$6 and a $1.50 jump range. Pretty good. There's a 10 tick bar. And you'll see strats in there. There's one right there. He jumps past both of them before. And then that gives you an up run. It's everything you talk about, Rob, on the long term. Happening by the microsecond inside the servers. There she goes. Another one. See? Up bar. You gotta put this in slow motion. There it is right there. Anyway, she's rolling. She jumped up to 5. Now it's running 496. Looks like it halted. Oh, she halted. Right there, she halted. She's running again. Take it over to this page. You can see it in the matrix. It's bouncing around. Jump on it at 450, you're right at the $6 if it does it. They were drinking at the 10-tick bar. There she goes. It's slow right now. See, this is a slow game. There's 25. You want to go longer? There's the stretch. 10, 15 seconds, 3 minutes, 1 minute, 30 minutes. That's today's activity. It stepped up and down. You got to get on it over here. If you get in there, you grab a quarter. That's for the guys that buy 4, 6, 8,000 shares at a time. But it's risky. If you put more than 20 to 100 shares on there, here's the jump again. Now, see, there's the next jump. That's the 10-tick bar. Take her back over here, and she jumped back up. That's a smaller, bigger scale. See? Jumping to $5. It's a 30-cent scale. Jumps 25 cents in 2 seconds. See the way it came right back down? Now if you take that out and stretch that over here, 15 seconds, you can see a cycle. Actually, what you want to look at here, we'll change this time frame to 25. And there you'll see the pattern. Usually the 10 gives you the pattern, but over here the 10's too tight. I'll open it up some. Reset it. I got that very light color. So you can see the distinction as it builds the bars. You want to watch the bars grow. Out of nothing. Can't get any finer resolution in that. It's too much activity in the server. And there it is at one tick. Okay. You can see it. It's just scatter dots. It's like a scatter gun. There you go. So there. This is all high speed activity, and you got slower activity right there. This is the graph over time. It looks like the energy graphs that we document right there. Open that up. And there it is there. Pull it down like that. Stretch it. You can hear the buy blinks. Buy and sell. Okay, those are big blocks. You gotta go to a different this shows it to you here, see? It's a different workspace. can see the huge blocks of shares being transferred, 2,000, 4,000, and the greens. There's 100 to 1,000 shares at a time, and there's 10 to 20 bursts of those. You want to analyze what's going on with the time and sales. Some people just stare at that all day and go in a trance watching that. Okay. About 2 hours later, they don't even know what they're looking at. They stare at the wall. I think they're still looking at the TNS flashing. That's a flat. Can't zoom out and you gotta pull it back. You can see both sides right there. That's the current flow right there. Buy into that, you got to buy it over here and sell it right there. This is a short-term deal. Okay, you got about 90 seconds to grab the run, maybe 30 or 40, sometimes 4 seconds. Guys, in 8 seconds, it went from $4 to $8, $6 in 8 seconds. And then you got to jump off. Just keep doing it over and over if you want to run that little bit, that little jump. Reset this one. There you go. That's 3 minutes. This is just today right there. You can see the pattern. This will give you a different pattern there. This bar here, that's an outside bar. Okay, that's between 8:45 and 9 o'clock. That's the first outside bar there. And then these are all inside bars. There's a small one, or they're overlap bars. Stratman knows more about that than I do. I'm just watching it as it flows on a high-speed situation. You're not going to do these actual broadening formations and all that. You try doing that on this, and before you get to draw it, it's already finished. You can actually predict, if we can get this right, we can predict a broadening formation about 3 minutes into the sale day, and then jump on it all the way up. That's the idea, right here. That's the idea. See the way these are a couple of days. You want to jump on this right here. You only need to jump on over there and jump off right here, and you're good. Then you can repeat if you want. Rinse and repeat, they call it. We're floating around 575 to 590. Okay, we could have jumped on right around here while she was flat, but it looked like it was going to dip. So we just sat there and looked at it. And here comes the next jumper. Sometimes you jump on over there and it rolls downhill. Otherwise, it climbs a mountain again. Okay, we're running right now 71 million shares. Okay, the 71,500,000. And 650,000, that big jump right there, boy. Ooh, 680. You're now up to 12 million shares more, 14 million shares more than the entire S&P for the day. That's what this is. Okay, that's what this is. I'm gonna reset this scale here and get it where it's jumping off. And there's your. It's not an outside bar, but it's an up bar. And you get some of these here while it's flat. And then it'll roll up again. And it takes off. Want to jump in right under $6. Right there. Try to find an outside bar while it's running back and forth like that. Most people don't have the patience to see it. You'll notice you get these flat closes. Okay, that's 25. You're gonna have to go to 10. You want to see more faster action. Now you're at 10. See a lot quicker action. Ride the slope. It's like being on a roller coaster. Yep, there you go. Here comes the big ones. bouncing back up over 6. There it is. See, it's like steps. See the steps? The volume can't keep up with the speed. That's what's happening right here. See? You don't know how many shares are being traded per tick. I don't even, I couldn't tell you that. I don't even, there's a nice one right there, boy, look at that. It's already off the screen. Close it. Go ahead and close the screen up. There you go. Close it up like that. And you're packing them. Packing them together. Now they build into sine waves. That's 10 tick activity. Compressed. You gotta compress it. See? I show you patterns like this on an oscilloscope running at 60 cycles with a 2 megahertz oscillation overlaid on top of it. You'll get a frequency looking just like that inside of an oscillator. Spike circuits give you the same exact type of look. You don't analyze the instantaneous activity. You're looking at the overall impact of the instantaneous activity on the fastest graph you can get without the display breaking up. You start pulling it back up, taking it apart again. Reset it. There it is right there. And she's dropped, now she's back below $6. And we're at the 75 million shares. And we went to 4 million shares here in the past 4 minutes. That's a million shares a minute. Okay. Jumping. Fish are jumping, buddy. Get a net in the water, quick. Activity is quiet at the moment. You can see the motion here. You're in a 1 minute bar. This is 10 tick bar. Everybody else is in a 1 minute bar. Last call on a 1 minute bar. The bar is closed. You're up at 650 and the bar closed before you could get out. Now you're down. There's 88 million shares and she just popped over $7. There's a market position we had before. Got out. That's only 3 minutes. They're riding up about a dollar and a half. Almost a half a buck up and down. You don't stay any longer than that because it's gonna, it falls back down and you lose money. You don't know, you never. 90 million, just turned 90 million shares. It's only an hour into the day, hour and 20 minutes. There's a drop right there. There's a drop. Got nice cycles, though. Uniform cycles in between. Between the runs and in between the flats. They're riding the $8 line now. 861, 850, you're crawling up over $8. There's the jump right there. From 7 to 8. Now it's in the eights. Jumping in the 8. You can hear how fast the ticks are going in the background. Those ticks are flying, baby. Oh, it comes down. Let's get into a different chart here. There's the internal. Need to reset it. So now you're in the eights. You get down here, and you can see this. This is a 15-second bar. So This would have been a good time to jump in right there in that little dot. These are jump dots, see? That's a flat time. If you go take it all the way back, you gotta shrink it down, you see where it started. Started down there, this is in the fives, and you keep going, and we're going way, way down. It started down in here, see? This is a day deal, okay? You jump in on the day deal. Open it back up. Where we got out over here, we were running between $4 and $6. Now it's up. Nope, there you go. She jumped over 9. It's going to $10. It's flat. Look at the flat top on it. See that? It's almost like a halt. And that's something that, here's your resistance level. Right there, you want to see it? That's a resistance level, a real-time resistance level, right there. Isn't that something? You got to get inside to see that. We're not talking these resistance levels where you make a line for the past 2 weeks. Collapse that a little bit and you'll see it. Here's the resistance level at 980. Just jump right over it. Hang right there. And then how long did it last? Okay, it lasted from, it lasted 30 seconds to 57. It lasted for 30 seconds, that resistance level. Reset the scale, let it roll. And that went up, that was at 9, and there's one at $9.50, and there's one at 8.80. We'll wind back. Can't see that on this one, see? That's inside these bars. That activity is happening inside these bars. It's 10 ticks. Take it to 1. That's what it looks like at 1 tick. You can hear the way it sounds like a Geiger counter on uranium. There's the scaling range reset. Got enough, it's got enough volume right now at 105 million where you can actually watch the one tick activity. And you get down to $2 or $3, all you get is little dots. That's the one tick activity right there. You get, and there's the flat tops. See? You get a whole slew of them where that's resistance right there by the penny. Okay? As it rolls up and down. Oh, reset it. Let's take it off. You can hear the Geiger counter going, okay? You just came to the uranium mine. There we go. See? That's a study in itself right there, buddy. That Strat soldier, dude. He's jumping up and down like a jack-in-the-box when he sees this stuff. Smoking now, boy. Look at that. Smoking. There's the volume. It's really smoking. 3,000, 7,000, 10,000 per lot. Per lot. It's really moving, boy. Really moving. 107 million, okay? 500,000. 600,000, okay? 700,000. Doing 100,000 shares a second. That's how it's smoking right now. Isn't that something? Oh, man. And here it is. Everybody else looks at this. That's a 15-second bar. They look at this. They look at a 1 minute. Okay, and that's all they got. You get a stinky swamp. Gives you 1 minute. And here's the big bar. See? There's a giant outside bar right there. And then she took off. Peaked up at 10 bucks. That's the outside bar that he talks about right there. Make it bigger. Big, big, big outside bar. And then all this activity come in. It's like a tsunami of share transactions. And now you can see it's starting to slow up a little bit after that. That was a big, huge wave of activity. Reset the scaling range. Now we drop it back to 10 ticks. Come on, 10 ticks. Okay, here it comes. It's using gigabytes of RAM to store all that. There she comes. It's reset. Now all of a sudden, see how quiet it down? Isn't that something? See? The wave gets up. It's like big energy flows. And now she's slowed up. Put this back on 15. And you can see that you can drill into it a little bit. And here it is. That giant bar you saw before is now broke up into two bars. You got a high bar and a low bar outside of all the previous activity. And then off that low bar, she dropped down. You had all these interconnecting bars right there. See? When it floated at that, it floated right at that price. That's almost like not even a resistance. It's just locked in at that price right there. And there's the strat outside with candles, and we'll change it to bars. You see right there, you change it to bars. And you see the same type of phenomenon. It holds itself right together. Switch it back and forth. There's candle. There's OHLC. But you can see that. The nice thing about this is you can actually see the interconnection between the opens and the closes, and when they're not aligned. See, the alignments jump when there's any kind of a gap. There's no gapping right now. You don't see that with this. You just see the close, and then you see the next candle. When you get the OHLC, it shows you the interconnection, and then where it jumped above right there and below. There you go. I've been running one tick. See the resistance level right there? Look at that. Lasted for a few seconds. Now you're getting a lot of activity. 1150, 1160. Those are all the bursts of buying and selling as it works up the curve. There we go. That's a lot of them right there, boy. Okay, you got 137 million shares, 100, 200, flat out, 500, 600, 700, another 100,000, 800,000, okay, 900,000, okay, 10, that's 138 million right there, just jumped another million shares. And you're watching it. You're watching it on the inside. She's jumped up to 12 bucks now. Okay, see, it's on a rise. Tearing up. It was flat as a pancake for about a minute, half a minute. Activity was down to nothing. Wasn't even ticking or anything. Now it's taking off. Now, there goes the peak. See, now she's pulling back down. And you look over here. And we look at the scale here. There she is coming down. Right there. See? That's it. It jumped across and it's going, oh, and there's the bar's done. That's 15 seconds. Go over here and take a look at the full complement. There you go. Set this one. And that's a 1 minute and it's still working on that bar. And the bar's not done yet. It's a 1 minute bar. It's still inside that bar. All that activity that you just looked at was all inside this bar and this bar right here. Now she's coming down. See how small the bar is? It's narrow. It's 100% narrow. And you go back to the other thing. Where is it? Over here. And you'll see how narrow it is. Staying inside the range. And it's flattening out. Back to this one. This is 25 ticks, and that's 10 ticks. The other one's one tick. There's the next bar here. These are 1 minute bars. That's what everybody else looks at. Okay. Down here we got a 3 minute bar. That's a slow bar. That's a snail bar. Glacier bar. Glacier speed. This is 30 minutes over here. You see this? all in the past 30 minutes. That right there is all in the past 30 minutes right there. 12:30, she's in there right now. Okay, he's bouncing around in the 12s. See that? That was a big, big bar there. This one was a lead up. This one was flat across, and then it stays inside. So this is the formation line. It's gonna either reach a peak and roll down, or it's just gonna keep on going. That's what nobody knows. You'll see it when you go look at the other grabs, the longer grabs. Now it's all slowed down. There's that burst we just looked at at high speed. And I see how it all slowed down, and now it's gonna run up again. There's the two sine wave cycles. 29, 11, 16, or 15. Now those are 14 second cycles. They're multiples of 7. The 7 second cycle is alive inside this. It's a 7 second cycle. Go back to the other screen here. And here's inside the one tick. You don't even see the cycles. Cycle up. And inside that cycle is those variations, and then that'll roll down now. See? Cycling down. Cycling down. Cycling up. See? Didn't cycle down very much. So that's the uptrend. Cycle down a little bit, cycle up. And it gets over the top and goes the opposite way. Cycle up. Okay, continue to cycle up. Now we're cycling down. Back up. These cycles are only 3.5 to 7 seconds. It's the 7 second cycle, it's the 3.5 second cycle. And here's the 7 seconds. Okay. Now you're now we're down. We're pulling down flat. There's the resistance right there. And now we're back up. That's the 7 second cycle right there. And things really slow down, then you can double it again. 14. Okay, it's a small. See how flat it is? Everything's slowing down. All the noise is slowing down. Activity is slowing down. Okay, and then it'll pick up the 3.5 minute cycle between the fast times and the slow times. Overall cycle. Here they are. She went down now. How wide the cycle is? Look, flat, flat, flat. Three flats. Well, like going down a set of stairs. Now it's waving. Wait, you got this wavering right there. The little baby sine waves. Or this is all happening within a nickel. All within a nickel. You pay it. Oh, there goes a lot of clicking. It's going to take off again. 11:17. Here comes the buyers. It was up over $12. Reset the range and let it roll. There she goes. She comes. Now look how flat that was right there. Look at that. All those trades were all at the same levels. That's something, boy. I don't know what kind of trades they are. Man, they're coming through. They're all at a specific level. Kick level. When it reverses. Pounding away. See how uniform those that pattern is? Jump and burst uniform. Okay. That would be a pulse width modulator. Okay, if you built an electronic circuit to make a pattern like that, it would be a pulse width modulator with spikes. Reset. Here we come. It went down for a while. Go look over here. See where it went. See where she went? She went down there, and then it got slow. Now it's ticking up. You can hear it picking back up again. This is a complete anthology of the activity. All of a sudden it stopped. Where'd the activity go? Was it halted? Not halted. Nope. It literally doesn't hold. Not a market hold. It's just a hold in the buying. All the trades went through, and then boom, here comes the next flow. And when you're watching candles that are 1 minute, 2 minute, 5 minutes, you don't know when that's happening. And then you see the motion, the little dot moving slowly. You got to monitor what's going on inside. The headlight on the front of the train watches every rail, every tie as he's going down the tracks. There we go. Snowing.